Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Welcome. This is video number 146, Introduction to Mathematics, lecture number 7. And today's topic is matrix algebra for undergraduate students of economics. And this is part 2. Let me start with matrix algebra. Here is the definition of a matrix. A matrix is any doubly subscripted array of elements arranged in rows and columns. Now, this is a doubly subscripted array of elements in rows and columns. These are rows and these are columns. So, a rectangular array of numbers in rows and columns is known as a matrix. So, this is matrix notation. These are the entries or elements of matrix, and we can write this Aij. A row matrix, it is a 1 by n matrix in which there is one row and n columns. And here is an example. A is equal A1, A2 up to An, and its dimension is Aj. This is a column vector in which there are m rows and one column. So there are m columns and one row. So m rows and one column, and we can write that Ai. A square matrix is a matrix in which the number of rows and columns are equal. This is matrix B, in which there are three rows and three columns. So this is known as a square matrix. Identity matrix. An identity matrix is a square matrix in which along the principal diagonals there are ones and off the diagonals there are all zeros. So if you look at this matrix, this is the principal diagonal and we have ones here and all the off diagonal are zeros. So this is an identity matrix. Transpose of a matrix. When we interchange the rows of columns, the rows and columns of a matrix, and when rows become columns and columns become rows, then the resultant matrix is known as transpose of A. And we either write A prime or we write AT, and then the rows are columns and columns are rows. So then the resultant matrix is known as the transpose matrix. Matrix addition and subtraction. A new matrix C may be defined as the additive combination of matrices A and B, where C is equal to A plus B is defined by C, Aij is equal Aij plus Bij. We must note that all three matrices are of the same dimension, that is Ij, I rows and J column. Addition. If A is equal A11, A12, A21, A22 and B is equal B11, B12, B21, B22, then C is equal A11 plus B11, A12 plus B12, A21 plus B21, A22 plus B22. Matrix addition example. Here is the addition of two matrices A and B, and the resultant matrix C is the addition of matrix A and B. Matrix subtraction. C is equal to A minus B, and it is defined by Cij is equal Aij minus Bij. Here is an example, and here we have matrix multiplication. Two matrices A and B can be multiplied if they have the same dimension and if the number of columns in one matrix is equal to the number of rows in the other matrix. So matrix A and B can be multiplied if, say for example, number of columns in this matrix is equal to number of rows in the other matrix, and where C is equal to S. And the resultant matrix will have the dimension of R by D, where R is the number of rows in the first matrix and D is the number of column in the second matrix. Here is an example. There are two matrices A and B, and C is the product of A, B. A is of dimension 2 by 3, and B is of dimension A is of dimension 2 by 2, and B is of dimension 2 by 3. So the resulting matrix will be of dimension 2 by 3, which is C, and you can see it. Here is another example. A is of dimension 3 by 2, and B is of dimension 2 by 3, so C will be of dimension 3 by 3. And if we solve the multiplication of A and B, then the resulting matrix will be this one: 5 2 8 2 1 3 and 1 1 1, and the dimension will be 3 by 3. Here is matrix inversion. Matrix inversion means, like, if we have the inverse of B matrix and we multiply it with B matrix, then it will be equal to the multiplication of matrix B with the inverse of B, and that will be finally equal to identity matrix. It means, if we multiply the inverse of any matrix with that matrix, then the resulting matrix will be an identity matrix. Like a reciprocal in scalar math, like the number one in the scalar math, that is identity. Linear system of simultaneous equations. Let us suppose we have x1 plus x2 is equal to say 6, and 2x1 plus x2 is equal to 9. We can write that in matrix notation, and we can solve that by this method. And finally, x1 is equal to 3 and x2 is equal to 3. So we can use that by inverse method and matrix multiplication, and finally we have answer of x1, x2. General form of an equation in n variables, and that is equal to summation j varies from 1 to n. Aij xj is equal bi, or ax is equal b. Unknown values of x can be found using the inverse of matrix A, such that x is equal to the inverse of A times x, and that is equal to the inverse of A times b, where b is A times x. Guerin-Lowry model, in which A times x plus y is equal to x. The object is to find x given A and y. This is done by solving for x. Y is equal identity matrix times x minus A times x, and that is equal y is equal to identity matrix minus A matrix times x, and that is equal to the inverse of identity matrix minus A matrix times y, and that is equal to x. So that is the value of x. Here is matrix operations in Excel. We can multiply two matrices A and B in Excel and select the cells in which the answer will appear. And then finally, we can give this formula, enter equal signs, M mult means matrix multiplication, and then we will give the range, and finally enter, and we will get this answer. So we can multiply two matrices in Excel to find out the product of these two matrices. Matrix inversion in Excel. Follow the same procedure. Select cells in which answer is to be displayed. Enter the formula. After equal sign, we write M inverse, that is matrix inversion, and then parentheses. Select cells containing the matrix to be inverted. Close parentheses. And press three keys, Control, Shift, Enter. This is again the definition of a matrix. It is a rectangular array of numbers with k rows and n columns. Rows are horizontal and columns are vertical. The numbers k and n are dimension of A. The numbers in the matrix are called its entries. The entry in row I and column j is called Aij. Sum and difference, we already have done this. You can follow the procedure. The sum of these two matrices is equal to this. This is scalar multiplication. If we have a scalar 2, we multiply this with this number, we get this. We multiply each and every element of this matrix, and then we get this matrix. Product of two matrices If we multiply this matrix by this matrix, we get this answer. If you multiply this matrix with this matrix, we get this one. And similarly, this is identity matrix for any m by n matrix A. A times identity matrix is equal to A, and for any n by m matrix B, identity matrix times B matrix is equal to matrix B. Laws of matrix algebra. The matrix addition, subtraction, scalar multiplication and matrix multiplication have the following properties. They follow associative laws. A plus B plus C is equal to A plus B plus C. A times B times C is equal to A times BC. Commutative law for addition. A plus B is equal to B plus A. Distributive laws. A into B plus C is equal matrix A times matrix B plus matrix A times matrix C. And A plus B times matrix C is equal A times C plus B times C. All these are in matrix. Transpose. The transpose AT of a matrix is the matrix obtained by A from A by writing its rows as columns. If A is n k by n matrix and B is equal to the transpose of A, then B is the n by k matrix with Bij equal Aji. If the transpose of A is equal to A, then A is symmetric. Here is an example. And we can verify these laws. Follow this. These are the determinants. The determinant is a scalar defined for a square matrix, and it is the sum of the selected products of the elements of the matrix, each product being multiplied by plus 1 or minus 1. And here is the way you can do that. And finally, here is an example, a numerical example. And if we simplify that, we finally get minus 3. So this is a scalar. This is inverse of a matrix. If a square matrix, I, for example, A has dimension n by n, matrix A is non-singular or invertible if there exists a matrix B such that AB is equal to BA is equal to identity matrix of n by n. For example, this matrix multiplied by this matrix is equal to this, and finally this is equal to identity matrix. So this one is the inverse of this matrix. The common notation for the inverse of a matrix is A raised to the power minus 1, or this is known as the inverse of A. The inverse matrix A minus 1 is unique when it exists. If A is invertible, the reciprocal of A or the inverse of A is also invertible. It implies A is the inverse of matrix, the inverse matrix of the inverse of A. That is, the inverse of the inverse of A is equal to A. If A is invertible matrix, then the transpose of A, the inverse of the transpose of A is equal to the transpose of the inverse of A. Matrix division. A by B is equal to A times the inverse of B. This is calculation of inversion using determinants. Follow this. Calculation of inversion using determinants. And this is calculation of inversion using Gaussian elimination method. Calculation of inversion using Gaussian elimination. Follow this. And finally, this matrix is then the matrix inverse of A. This is systems of equation in matrix form. If we have this system of equation, this is equal to B1, and this whole equation is equal to B2, and finally this is equal to BK. So we can write these as metric equation AX is equal B, where A is equal to this matrix, X is equal to this column vector, and B is equal to this column vector of constants. If n by n matrix A is invertible, then it is non-singular, and the unique solution to the system of linear equation Ax is equal to b and x is equal to A inverse b. And here is an example. And if we solve this system of equation by matrix inversion method, then the final answer are this. X is equal to 1 by 2, Y is equal to 1 by 3, and Z is equal to 5 by 6. This is how you do that in MATLAB. This is positive definite matrix, negative definite, positive definite, positive semi-definite, negative semi-definite, indefinite matrix, and so on. Follow this, ladies and gentlemen. This is a brief introduction of part 2, matrix algebra for undergraduate students of economics. I hope this is an interesting presentation. You may subscribe to the channel, and please do not forget to click on bell icons for my latest videos on the channel. Thank you, and have a good afternoon.